side box for my welding table so I can put my tools in and get a little more organized. I'm just laying out the pattern now. Doing 4-inch sections. I don't think you can see the lines. Yeah, there you can. Yeah, just kind of setting it out. Yeah. Getting whitewashed a bit. Set up my lines, kind of get an idea of what I'm doing here. Kind of temporary, just kind of make it out of paper so I kind of know what I'm doing here and get make sure it fits before you cut the metal. That'll be the little hem I put it on. And notch is where I cut out when I put up the fold up the hinges. Need the notch because when you fold it'll run into each other when you put the hem on there. Now use the finger brake on it. And kind of be our notches there for the folds. Kind of mark it out there. And what I'll do when I get the metal, I'll notch that out. Fold the hems up. And then fold these two. And I'll do that on the finger brake over there. Just the little nippers out, so you got to and get your notches in there so when you fold it up and you know exactly. Kind of give it a test. There's the pattern. And I'll be back in a minute. Okay, now I got the little piece of steel here cut out. It's a little bit bigger than what I need. Get our pattern set on there where we need it. Get it lined up where it's nice and flush. magnets on it to hold it. Marking where we need it. On this piece, put a little slip there so it'll catch on the lip. And right where to cut it. Actually lock right into the I gotta cut the end there a little bit to get I'll line that up with the blade on the cutter or on the shear, and that'll lock in and it'll cut right on that line. I'm gonna get you set up to check that out. Okay, here we are over at 3-in-1. And little cuts I put in there, slide it in there. You gotta adjust that one a little bit more. Bend it over a little bit more. Slide that in there. So it hooks in there. And cutting it. See, cut right on the line. And then we'll get this side. Okay, now this side's just the same as the other side. Get it in there, hook it on both your slits you cut. Go. Got a nice straight square line. And we're back over here at the bench. Get our template on there. Looks good. Snips. Got our reliefs out for the 90s. Get the bending. go. Then we go back over to 3-in-1. Use the brake on it. And we'll get you set back up for that. And now we're back over here to 3-in-1. Combination here to get 20. I'm gonna have to switch my fingers around. There we go, that wasn't too bad. Holding them in. Get our bolts tightened up. It's been a nice little machine. I mean, it took quite a bit to set it up and stuff because things were loose and whatever, you know, Harbor Freight stuff. But so far, it's been pretty handy. What I've been doing, I've just been working with 20 gauge. And that's probably about as much as this little machine to handle. Yeah, all this stuff, I had to square the blade up, adjust the cutting blade, had to play around with the rollers a little bit, make sure everything was lubed up, tightened, and squared up. Now, got our 20 inch set. Get our box set here. Bit of finesse to get it. And there we go. There's the one side. Get in here and get to it. There we go. there we go. There's the basics of our box. Got a little trimming or whatever to do, but get them corners fit a little better. That's that. And then where this is going, get it done. Bolt hole there, and bolt hole there. And there's little nuts in there for the side doohickey. And then we'll mount that right there. And I can slide tools or whatever in there and be out of the way instead of being up there on top of the table. Get back again. I gotta make the sides and get the sides in, and I'll get back with you. Stuff up a little bit while I'm on it. Clean enough. And I'll turn you around here. Get you set up there. There we go. backed in. Get a couple more tacks on it and get it mounted up. I'll get back with you when I'm ready to mount it. Okay, we're good to go. Got the sides tacked up, got my holes on there now. And we'll just get it bolted on there. Get the essentials in there. And now keep my work area clean. Now I gotta figure out something to do with my welding rod. Till next time, see you later. Yeah, it turned out to be a pretty good project. And yeah, I needed something to get my tools in. I was tired of welding and having everything all over the table. I can toss my clamps and stuff in there. I have more workspace. It'll catch you on the next one.